Hey, it's been a long time since we've seen this set.
Yes.
The Charlie Wilson's KitchenAid kitchen. I'll make a note that the fire extinguisher is right off of Claudia's left shoulder.
First thing we ask is, how do we turn on the stove? But don't worry, it's going to be great.
Everything's
fine. It's been, though, too long since we've actually had a chef whip up something special for the Great Day Live team. So today we're bringing that back, and just in time for all the tailgates and the fall cookouts, our favorite time of year.
So joining us virtually right now from his kitchen at Ada, just actually down the street from us, we're neighbors right here on Chestnut, we've got Chef Henry Wesley, gonna teach us how to make one of their most popular menu items. We're talking about beer queso. Good morning to you, Chef.
Good morning. How are you doing?
Good. So we have done some prep work here. We've folded in the cheese.
We
did that, and then we kind of prepped some chorizo.
Yes.
I'm gonna go ahead and get my cheese in the pot. You guys are one step ahead of me. What I got here is a little bit of milk already scoured. We got that heated up to a nice temperature. I'm just gonna go ahead and pour my cheese right in the pot. This is a really, really easy recipe.
Yep.
Just a few steps. Anybody can whip this up at home, or you can come enjoy it on our rooftop patio down here. So I'm just gonna get all my cheese in the pot. You wanna make it nice and cheesy there. All right.
So this is perfect for tailgating too.
Yeah, it is. Actually, it travels super well. Super easy to make, something you can whip up on the afternoon, just right before, or the morning right before. So if I'm getting my cheese stirred in, you see I'm just whipping that in nicely here.
Hey, yeah. Chef Henry, is it okay if, like, we, for consistency purposes on the cheese, like, we added in a little bit more milk? I mean, can you do that? Do you have to follow the recipe?
Yeah, so
we decided to change the consistency.
So however you really like it, if you want a little bit more thinner, you can put a little bit more milk, or if you want a little bit more cheesy, also you can add a little bit more cheese. It's just kind of up to you what consistency you want. After you get the base recipe down, I really want you to feel free to play with it and make it your own, right? So after we've gotten the cheese kind of mixed in there, it's really simple. We're going to go ahead and put in our pickled jalapenos.
Okay.
Dump that all in.
Just pour them all in?
Pour all of that in. Just gonna stir it up. And then we're gonna add in some of our jalapeno juice here.
You did good, Eric. He did so good here, Chef. He's doing so good. I am so proud of Eric.
I'm killing it.
I really hope he doesn't mess this up. I heard we're trying to keep you away from the stove a little bit.
I love that the chef has great utensils and everything. He's got a big old cheese whisk, and we've got this that we found in the other studio.
All right, and for the final step here, we're almost done here. We're just going to add a little bit of this Guinness beer.
Okay.
We're just going to pour that right in.
He said a little bit, Claudia.
How much?
A little bit.
Maybe a lot, okay?
Maybe a lot. Okay.
Okay, that's...
Is that enough?
Well, you're turning the cheese into water.
It is a tailgate party, right, Chef? The more beer, the better.
Come on, it's all about the beer and the football, having a great time with friends.
Oh, I can smell that.
Everybody's excited to be able to get back out and enjoy football season again. So this is just a great item. So after this is all done here, it should be nice and ready to go. I'm going to use a little bit of TV magic.
All right.
Is that the chorizo?
Yeah, so the chorizo we're going to use to finish this off. We kind of don't want it to get lost inside the cheese sauce.
Don't lose the chorizo.
We don't want it to get lost. Right. Okay, I go ahead and pour it in?
So
pour it
here
in?
After we have our cheese sauce ready, we're just going to go ahead and scoop this out, okay?
Okay.
I'm going to scoop some out into a bowl.
Oh, yeah.
So do I mix the chorizo into...
We're going to top it right on top.
Oh, you put it
on top. And then we're going to mix it.
So, okay, we need to...
We don't have a fancy... Ladle. Okay, we need a ladle. Is that what you call a ladle?
We'll just do it old school. We'll do it like this.
School.
Just set it down, Claudia. Set it down.
Okay.
Because I'll get cheese all over you.
And then we put the is it chorizo?
Chorizo.
Chorizo.
Stop making up words. You're embarrassing me in front of our peers.
Right? Just drizzle it on the top. You know what I meant, Chef Henry. I know you know what I meant.
I'm so embarrassed for you.
Oh, yeah. Looking good, guys. Looking good.
Let's see what yours looks like. Hold that up. Let me see how pretty you did that.
Right,
he did his a lot better than mine.
Oh, that's perfect.
That's perfect. All right. Beautiful.
It looks really good. And I like to finish off with a little bit of micro cilantro. This is totally
cilantro.
Up to you guys. But, you know,
ooh, a garnish.
A little bit fancy in the restaurant.
I didn't get you a garnish.
Here you go, that's right here, guys.
Fantastic.
Hey, thank you so much. We've got some great beer cheese here with chorizo. We've got chips. Oh, we actually did have a presentation bowl that we'll use that later.
Yes.
We'll bring it back to the control room as prompted in our ear by our director. We will not forget about you. Chef, hey, thank you so very much. Remind everyone where they can find you.
We are down here at 8UP, located at 350 West Chestnut Street on the rooftop of the Hilton Garden Inn. We're open Monday through Sunday from 5 p.m. to 10 p.m. We're hoping to see you guys soon. We're getting ready to open up our famous igloos at the end of October. So welcoming the whole city. Hopefully you guys can get back out and start enjoying some activities again.
That is perfect.
Thank you so much.
Those igloos are fantastic. Chef, hey, thank you so very much.